Hi there, my name is Megan, and I'm a teacher here at Treehouse. My pronouns are she, her, hers. In this course, I'm excited to show you SQL Alchemy. SQL Alchemy is an ORM, or Object Relational Mapper. It's a Python code library that transfers data stored in a SQL database into Python objects. You can then use Python code to create, read, update, and delete data instead of writing straight SQL, which helps speed up development time, especially for developers who are not fluent in SQL. And it can often make managing data less error-prone. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. It's a language for interacting with relational databases. Relational databases are structured like a traditional table with columns and rows. If you're not familiar with SQL, I highly suggest taking a peek at the prerequisites for this course. I've also listed them in the teacher's notes below. This prior knowledge will bridge the gap between working with a database using SQL and working with a database using Python's SQL Alchemy. If you would like to follow along in Workspaces, then go ahead and open up the workspace attached to this video. In the console, run pip install SQL Alchemy. Hit enter. Let it download. And you're all set. If you would like to follow along locally, create a folder for your project and open it in your IDE of choice. I'm going to use Visual Studio. I'm going to go ahead and create our models.py file. We'll need to download SQL Alchemy so we can use it. But first, let's create a virtual environment. Create a virtual environment by running Python if you're on Windows and Python 3 if you're on a Mac like I am, -m vnv env, and this will start your virtual environment. You can see it's asking if I want to use it. I do. And you see our folder up here was created, and VS Code also adds its own little thing. You don't need to worry about it. Okay. Now that we have our virtual environment created, we need to activate it. Now, if you're on Windows, you need to write, and I need to make sure I get my slashes correctly, /env/scripts/activate, if you're on Windows. If you're on Mac, then you need to write it as source /environment/bin/activate. And this is all in the teacher's notes below as well. So you can reference it at any time. So go ahead and type that out, whichever one you need. Hit enter. And now you can see I have this env here because I am now inside of my virtual environment. Perfect. Now we can install SQL Alchemy. Same install, pip install SQL Alchemy. Awesome. And then we can run pip freeze caret or arrow to the right requirements.txt. This is the file that will be important for others. And if I run it, it will create this file. And if I click into it, it'll tell me SQL Alchemy has been installed. And this is the version that I'm currently using. Our requirements file is ready. If you want to create a repo for this project and others end up wanting to run your project to check it out, they will need this file. If you do want to post this on GitHub, then let's also create a Git Ignore file. New file, .gitignore. Inside, we're going to write env. This will make sure that environment folder does not get shared to your repo. You don't want that to go up. We can also do this .vs code if you're like me and you're working in VS Code. .vs code, we don't need that to go up either. That's just for us locally here.
There's also this .ds store on Macs that sometimes get pushed up. You don't want those to go either, so you can add that to your Git Ignore file. And that should be good for right now. The most important one is your environment folder. This has a whole bunch of downloads in it, and anyone running your project only needs the requirements file to download those requirements themselves. So we don't want to send them all of our files. They can download it for themselves. Okay, cool. Now that you have either workspaces or your local environment set up, let's check our version in the Python shell. I'm going to run a clear. Then I'm going to go Python 3 to make sure I'm in the newer version of Python. And then I'm going to import at the top SQL Alchemy. Awesome. And then I'm going to run SQL Alchemy dot dunder version, double underscore version, double underscore. And awesome. It's the same version that's in our requirements file, but this is another way that you can check your version number. You can see I'm on version 1.3.22. And your version may be different. And that's okay. Technologies change quite frequently. So if you're on a newer version than I am, make sure to check the teacher's notes throughout the course. This way you get the most up-to-date information to go along with your version. We're all set. Time to dive in.